Are you proud of your Christmas tree?
Of course, last 10 years I'm doing everything myself, so.
But just look at the detailing on this tree.
This is one of my favorite.
Yeah.
Chicken de Toscano. Christmas plum cake.
So Shri, your Christmas tree is up?
Yep.
Huh?
Yeah.
Is it looking nice?
Yes, thank you.
Are you proud of your Christmas tree?
Of course, last 10 years I'm doing everything myself, so but kind of adding little bit more decorations each year.
And I must say, she's done a fantastic job. So this is a tradition which Shri, so for the last
many years
she's been putting up the Christmas tree. And when she says 10 years, she's talking about this place. And I think more than me, she's always enthusiastic about Christmas. And this tree is entirely her doing. I put the tree together, that's all that I do, and I think that's the easiest part of putting up a Christmas tree. But the decorations that go into it, right, the detailing that you see here, I mean, I don't know how many ornaments there must be in this. There must be, you know, dangling on every branch. Shri gets the credit for all that. So actually she gets a credit for the whole tree.
Nothing like that. That the basic foundation is also yours, right? So without that I wouldn't have decorated it. So
she just gave me some brownie points, like basic foundation and all that. But just look at the detailing on this tree. There are so many ornaments, right from the star at the top, you know, coming down to the bells, you know, the Santas, the stars, the miniature gifts. The Santa light, so this is something that our friend gave us. Yeah, and so I've put this light up. I mean, that's the only thing that I've done here. Yeah, so if you look at all the effort that's gone in, so it's entirely Shri's doing. She's very modest about. How long did it take you, Shri?
No, not much, because being doing it for a while, for so many years, right? It doesn't take that long.
Kind of feels like Christmas. That's the whole thing about, I think, having that Christmas tree. These are decorations that we've you know, have collected over time, and then there are also those that have probably come to us as gifts,
right?
So when you look at some of those ornaments, you also think about those people. Christmas time is also about being thoughtful, about having people in your thoughts, your loved ones, your near and dear ones, and also those that are probably not, you know, as privileged, as blessed. I think that's the whole meaning of Christmas. But I think what this tree does is that it puts us in a whole spirit.
Yeah. See, in the US and all, after Halloween, that is in the first or second week of November itself, they put it up, just before Thanksgiving. So that, you know, that during that winters, in that, you know, it feels so good to see the colorful lights all over, all the wreath, and even the outside I have kept it, my wreath, everything.
Mm.
So entrance, so it feels good, you know, this 1 month, you know, you feel happy, bright colors.
So I don't know when you will see this vlog, maybe you'll see this vlog closer to Christmas, but as we film this, we are in early December, and this tree, I think, went up.
Yeah, end of November.
It went up end of November. So we are basically going to watch this tree and feel Christmassy all of December, and I think
first week of Jan
is when the tree comes down. And again, Shri will painstakingly take away all the ornaments one by one, pack them nicely, and at the end of it I will just come and dismantle the tree. So it kind of it's very unequal division of labor, but I think you know, she does the tree really well. So I think all credit for the Christmas tree here goes to Shri.
Thank you.
Do you have a favorite ornament?
Not really. I like most of them.
Of all the ornaments that you've put up?
I like. Some of these things are, you know, done by my friend, you know, the crochet, you know.
So those are snowflakes.
Snowflakes. She's gifted me this time.
When you look at Christmas trees that are loaded with ornaments, you also know that that tradition has continued for a long time.
Yeah.
Because you can't really, you know, get all of it together and then just put it up. I mean, it's very difficult to do that. And secondly, it doesn't really feel, I don't know, what's the word?
Every year, you know, I do collect like 5-6 new ones.
Yeah.
So in a period of time, we have about like 150-200 ornaments.
Yeah, do you count them?
Yeah, because keep packing, right?
Yeah, so since she has the arduous task of taking it out, putting it up on the tree, and also then later removing it from the tree, she knows exactly. Yeah, so the spirit of Christmas is
here
and alive and well. So I hope you liked, you enjoyed our Christmas tree. Our Christmas tree, with all the effort by the boss. It's a Saturday here and we just thought we'd step out. We're going to spend some time out, do a meal with our daughter. I don't think you'll see her in the vlog because she's very particular about not appearing on the vlogs.
Right.
I will try to make a case and see if we get at least a frame of her, but I'm not sure. But yeah, so today the plan is to kind of just step out, just relax, have a leisurely lunch and
coffee, anything.
Any retail is happening today?
Not really.
That smile, doesn't it say it all, whether it's really going to happen or not? But yeah, so since we began this with the Christmas tree, we'll probably keep the vlog going for a bit. Let's see where it takes us.
There's
a typical Saturday traffic. People are stepping out more and more now.
The traffic is like the pandemic, and I would say even 10-20% more.
I think people just want to step out and do what they need to do. I mean, even we are stepping out, so. But I just hope that, you know, one takes precautions, you know, wears masks, still tries and keeps that social distance, and most importantly, vaccinations. I think you got to make sure, I think today in the least, you got to make sure that you're fully vaccinated. And in the US, they're giving boosters now. So I think probably that will come here too. And if at all that comes here, I think we should get ourselves boosted too. Even as we want to get into that festive spirit, there is that cloud of uncertainty. And I think one can just hope and pray that it isn't someone's worst nightmare.
Correct.
I think Christmas is also about being thankful.
Yeah.
Right? For everything that you have that, you know, others may not be enjoying. To think about that and to do what you can. So in fact, this particular month, our focus at Gourmet on the Road, at Food Lovers TV, also Kripala Mana Vlogs, is to try and showcase as many smaller unsung places as we can. You know, sometimes you ask me as to why do I differentiate between the two. Firstly, I think most of the episodes that you see on Kripala Mana Vlogs are mostly self-shot. So the production is a very casual, very not so slick, but it still conveys the story. Because I think at the end of the day, it's a story that you want to tell, and how you tell the story that is important, that ultimately connects to the viewer. And the second aspect from an establishment perspective is that not every eatery will be able to handle the kind of upsurge that they may see. Possible upsurge, I'm not trying to be presumptuous or vain here. The possible upsurge that may arise out of, let's say, being featured on a Food Lovers TV. So I think that's the reason why the Kripala Mana Vlogs also helps establishments kind of somehow try and manage with the response that it creates. Although even there today and now, we're seeing responses, we're seeing viewership in large numbers. So although we only have about 1 lakh or plus subscribers on the second channel, on this channel, the channel that you're watching it on, but I think the viewership goes much beyond the number of people subscribed to the channel.
That is our way of, you know, being thankful and trying to do what we can.
Giving back something.
Giving back. And and of course, I think for Shri, that's a big part of what she does.
Should not say all that.
You know, also when you see places like these, this for example used to be there used to be a Shopper Stop here, right?
Yeah.
And no longer there. I think so many businesses have been impacted in the last couple of years, especially the last 1 year. You're seeing so many of them that have literally shuttered. If you can do something for us, at least some of these smaller establishments that find it very difficult. And I think we can all do that, right? Wherever you are, no matter, you know, which neighborhood, which city, which country, I think if you look around, you will find these small enterprises that, you know, are doing their best to do what they can. Whether, let's say, if it's a eatery, they're doing their best to serve us some great food, but they're having a tough time trying to just cope. All of us collectively can do so much for them, and I think that's something that we should think about even as we celebrate the spirit of Christmas this year. Try and get on a ride tomorrow.
Tomorrow we have to go to Abhijit and Shruti's.
Still try to get like a short ride, no? When did I ride the fat boy last? 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
So with the fat boy, if I don't ride it like 2-3 weeks,
the battery goes.
Yeah, the battery gets discharged. So I think I will ride tomorrow. Even a short ride. Actually today I thought I will do it, but then since we were stepping out, when I see people riding, I'm like, oh, I have to ride my motorcycle too. Becomes rather busy with the work that we're doing sometimes. Yes, I am.
I watch your video.
Oh, okay, thank you very much. That's Sunaina. She's here, but she is. This is allowed, no?
No, it's not even a nice. Dada, please stop it.
It's nice when you
take it. It's a nice picture. How is it? This is almost like a pizza, right?
I know. Let's not order pizza.
You order something else. What do you want for Christmas? Let's bring our conversation to something that may interest you. Love. I can give you a lot of
there.
Love. I can give you like a big hug.
That is always there.
Love and kisses. Lot of hugs.
Other than that, she's saying other than that.
That is always there.
Other salad?
Yes.
Yeah. How's your salad? This is nice. You want to have some of the soup?
You were in Paris, right? You were in France.
Yes. Oh, in France. That's
what a beautiful house and.
Now, the chalet now, this morning in semi video, full snow. But so much more, incredible, like, over.
Very good.
Snow, over the snow.
Ramesh, excellent coffee.
Good.
For me, this is like...
It's hot. Yeah.
Hot, strong, perfect.
Good.
This is still as good, huh? This is one one of my favorite.
Yeah.
Chicken de Toscano.
Chicken de Toscano.
So this is inside is what? Goat cheese and then.
They change a little bit.
But what are the greens?
Yeah, but spinach is there.
Mm.
And they put some nerves and this and that and this.
And the ratatouille. Christmas plum cake. Why not?
Good.
It's nice and moist.
Yeah, no dry, no bitter. We do the fruit.
How long do you macerate the fruit in the liquor? 3 months. Very nice.
A lot of alcohol.
In this you can also taste the, you know, the warming effect of the alcohol, right? That's what's very good.
How about more, no?
Do you sell this?
No.
So good lunch with Sunaina, but of course Sunaina doesn't want to be on the vlog because what happened was when we did the anniversary vlog, I think one of our first few vlogs, I think that video really went, you know, got a huge number of views and then she got a lot of attention, a lot of requests, etc. on Instagram and so that didn't really go down too well with her and you know, also of course with Shree she's always around and she's very sporting enough to be on these vlogs and I guess she doesn't have
a choice
really.
Yeah,
so they've closed Maridara. Where the roads are dark. Shree, okay, according to Shree she doesn't have a choice so she has to be in this vlog. Sunaina has a choice so she exercises her choice rather forcefully and I don't really want to, you know, at the end of the day they all have their, she's an adult, a young adult and she values her privacy which is fine, which is great. So yes, so therefore I couldn't really bring too much of lunch to you. I mean, you've seen some of the plates. We were lunching at Toscano in UB City. We like the atmosphere there, very Christmassy and you know, to be amongst people. We've got a vlog on Toscano when Shree and I had lunch there at their Whitefield outlet some time ago. So if you haven't caught that, I'm going to place a link here also in the description below. Just going to go back home, kick back after that lunch. A little bit of retail therapy as well. The boss is smiling.
Yeah.
And so yeah, so that's the day for today. So I just wanted to share with you the Christmas tree and we said, okay, fine, let's also add some other aspects of the day to make it a slice of life sort of a vlog. I hope you found it interesting. I hope you like the Christmas tree at least. The effort that's, all the effort that's put in by Shree, because that's her department and something that she cherishes, something that she loves doing. So I think on that note, it's time to close this vlog here. Wish you guys a wonderful Christmas and the very best for the new year, for 2022. Wish you joy, happiness, and more importantly, good health. So Merry Christmas, folks, and we'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.
Happy holidays and Happy New Year to all of you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.